During the inspection, the members of parliament were brought up to speed with the developments of various projects that are currently underway.
So we are happy that the works here have progressed. We almost at the tail end, as you can see the lights here, and the bus bars are live. The transformers are energized, so they are in the final testing phase, and then doing the substation leveling works.
I think as a person, as a representative of the people, I have been able to see this. I appreciate the effort. The last time we were here, the works were not at this stage. We have come back, we have seen for ourselves. We will proceed from here to be able to see what is happening at Ashwa. The good news is that Ashwa is evacuating here about 50 megawatts. Karuma is already here. Lira is already here. So this is a very good news going forward as we look forward to West Nile being connected onto the national grid. West Nile has waited for stable and industrial reliable electricity from 1914 when West Nile became part of Uganda.
Key among these is the Kolegulu Nebi Arua transmission project that will extend the national grid to West Nile and improve power reliability in northern Uganda. West Nile and Greater Northern Uganda are expected to have the best reliability of supply in the country due to the available options once these projects are completed.
Yes, they say right now that they need to see that business comes and taps this power. The power should not just be redundant. It will be possible. If you don't see business community very active now.
During the tour, the committee also visited Kakira Coal Generation Facility, Mayuge Solar Plant, Mbale Industrial Park, Achwa Hydro Power, among others. It's estimated that Kolegulu Nebi Arua Transmission Project will be completed by the end of March next year to connect West Nile to the national grid. Story by Benin Ochambo for the news.